To use the Tonex pedal as an audio interface, you need to do three things. The first thing is in the pedal itself. The Tonex pedal is designed to be used in two different ways, both as a standalone unit. Everything you play comes from this preset here, all the knobs here affect the sound, and so on. But in this case, you can't use it as an audio interface. If you plug it in with your USB cable, you won't hear any sounds. And that is because you have to manually set the pedal how it should be used. To change it from a standalone unit to audio interface, you need to press this button here. Sorry, hold it in. The presets, change it to global settings, press again, switch to it's called operation. Press the button here, and we will start for most of you on live. Live means it's a standalone unit and it can't be used as an audio interface. To change it to interface, you need to switch it to interface. So from live to interface and press. Now it can be used as an ordinary audio interface. But a very important thing is this is the selected preset on the pedal, A, B, and C. Regardless if you have selected this as a standalone unit or an audio interface, this preset will get mixed into the signal into your computer. So to disable this one, regardless of which settings you use, just press it again so it flashes. Now everything you can hear on your computer is only the preset in like the Tonex software on the DAW, nothing from the pedal. But if you it's a light like this, you will mix the signal from the pedal, this preset, with the preset you have on your computer. So always disable this one if you want to use it in that way. To connect it to your computer, you have this USB cable, which is included in the pedal. Yes, connect it to an ordinary USB port on your computer. The next step is to set up your Tonex software to recognize this as an audio interface. In addition, if you want to send two different signals to your computer, one dry signal without any effects, and one wet signal, which has a sound from the pedal, you can do that if you want to. To access that, you again go hold in down this button, switch to global settings, then go to right hand side again. Here is your operation, which you just changed. Then you're on the right, you have USB out. Press button and you have dual, which I set this up. And that means you have one output, which is wet with the signal, and one signal which is dry without any effects from the unit. So by default, I think it's stereo, which means that you all get all the effects on all inputs. Again, if you want to use one dry signal and one wet signal, change this to dual, press the button, go back, and now you will send two different signals to your DAW. Now I open up the Tonex software. If you want to use the pedal as an audio interface, you'll go to your top right hand side here, press. And here you have your technology, which basically is which driver you want to use, or use ASU. And here you have your instrument input. And here you can see you have one and two. And as I just explained, if you set your USB out as dual, the one is the wet signal with effects, and two is your dry signal. So if you want to use this software and sounds from here, you should always use the second channel because you don't want to blend, or you might want to, but most often you don't want to blend the pedal sound with the sound from this software. So use the second here, and here's your monitor output, which means where you want the sound, where you want to send the sound when you play. If you do it like this, you can use a headphone connected to your pedal and you get all the sounds from that. That is also very useful if you play a backing track or something on your computer. You can hear that blended with your sound as well. I think that's very nice. The same applies in DLW. I use Reaper. To make the pedal as audio interface, you need to choose that I think it's the same procedure in all DAWs. In Reaper you have preferences, audio and device, and here you set the same thing. You have ASU as the audio system, driver is the Tonex ASU driver, and here are your inputs. When you activate a track, you can see here you have both applicable. Again, the second one is the dry signal and the first one is the wet signal. That means that you can at the same time track in both the pedal sound and a dry signal for reamping, which I think is a cool feature to use. If you have any questions about this, don't hesitate to ask below. I will really get to as many as possible. Thank you for watching and have a great day.